And before God, we are united in prayer and in love and now we're going to play two goals. Kieran, you have to go forward. The line is two candles, so you might take the flowers.
First reading, a reading from the Song of Songs. I hear my beloved, see how he comes leaping on the mountains, bounding over the hills. My beloved is like a gazelle, like a young stag. See where he stands behind our wall. He looks in at the windows, he peers through the lattice. My lovely one, come. My beloved lifts up his voice. He says to me then, come then, my lovely one, come. My dove, hiding in the clefts of the rock, in the covert of the cliff, show me your face. Let me hear your voice, for your voice is sweet and your face is beautiful. My beloved is mine and I am his. Set me as a seal upon your heart, as a seal on your arm. For love is strong as death, jealousy, relentless as shore. The flash of it is a flash of fire, a flame of the Lord himself. Love no flood can quench, no torrents drown. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks.
Second reading, a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Be ambitious for the higher gifts, and I am going to show you a way that is better to attain. If I have all the eloquence of men or of angels, but speak without love, I am simply a god only or a single fashion. If I have the gift of prophecy, understanding all the mysteries there are, and knowing everything, and if I have faith in all its fullness, to move mountains, but without love, then I am nothing at all. If I give away all that I possess, piece by piece, and if I even let them take my body to burn it, but I am without love, it will do me no good whatever. Love is always patient and kind. It is never jealous. Love is never boastful or conceited. It is never rude or selfish. It does not take offense, and it is not resentful. Love takes no pleasure in other people's sins, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse, to trust, to hope, and to endure whatever comes. Love does not come to an end. This is the word of God.
This is a promising day for all of you, Eimear and Kieran. You make promises that will shape the rest of your lives, the rest of your life's journey together. There's that lovely play, I don't know if you know of it, Translations, have you ever come across the play yet? Yeah. And Yallard and Laura are likely a couple of fall in love, and she only speaks Irish, he speaks only English. And they both trip upon one word, and they keep asking each other, what's that word mean? The word they both trip over is always. What's that word, always? He says he would love her always, she says she would love him always. But they can't figure out what the word in English or Irish always means. very famous, very moving character, a Lutheran minister called Dietrich Bonhoeffer. He died in a Nazi camp, but he wrote a letter to his niece just as she was about to get married. And he wrote some very wise lines. And I've used these are the only lines I use really, maybe not on marriage, but it's funny the number of people who pick up on these lines. And he wrote to his niece, who was waiting, he couldn't do, in a lovely letter. And these are the immortal words that are always echoed by many people. It's not the love, he says, that will sustain your marriage or your promises, but it's your marriage, your promises, will sustain your love. In the spring and in the summer of your love, Eimear and Kieran, that might not seem obvious. But I can tell you, people on the road to marriage who are sitting around you will know the wisdom of those words. Because love has its seasons. And in the summer and the spring of your love, that might not seem obvious, but you know, love also has its autumns and its winter. And in those seasons, remember those words. The months and years ahead, and the twists and turns, the blessings and crises which make up life and flesh out those promises for you. In 25 or 50 years from now, please God, you will both look back together with Kieran Oak and many others, and to know what all that really means. And as you look back, it will be the promises of loyalty to each other that you make this very day, this very moment. It will be that steady, stable, and sure resolve to be there for each other, come what may, that will sustain you. It will be knowing that whatever you have to face, disappointment, hardships, doubt, and illness, you will face it together. And the promise that you will never walk away. That whenever you reach out your hand, as you will shortly, you know that you will find each other's hand to hold tenderly, gently to reassure, and to give each other strength in the unspoken presence of love, come what may, doing together what neither of you could be able to do alone. You set yourselves, the lovely words there from, as I was listening to them again, you know, you set yourselves as seals upon your heart this very day. Never forget that. Your promise of always being there for each other will allow you to redeem disappointments, hurts, and misunderstandings with forgiveness, patience, and understanding. That promise of always will transform your love today into a loyalty that is love, and a loyalty, and a love that is loyalty. And as you face into the unknown future, you and Kieran, not only do you put your faith and trust in each other today, but as two people of faith, you put your trust also in God, your faith in God. Another New Year poem by Millie Haskins, a famous, I suppose, during World War II. I said to the man who stood at the gate of the New Year, give me a light that I may tread safely into the unknown. And he replied, go out into the darkness and put your hand into the hand of God. That shall be to you better than light and safer than a known way. So I went forth, and finding the hand of God, trod gladly into the night. So both of you, not only holding each other's hands today, but holding God's hand, you trod into the night, into the unknown. It allows you to strive and dare for something different when you put your hands into the hands of God, really meaningful and enduring. And in the gospel you chose, there's a lovely line, made in my love. It's both an invitation and a challenge. When you do remain in God's love, then you commit to and to draw on a generosity, a tenderness and forgiveness that can reflect the measure of not only another as I have loved you. This is no pious exhortation, because sometimes that loving as I have loved you in the gospel is what will make the difference. For there will be moments you will need God's help to call out a forgiveness, a tenderness, and a generosity that is more than you can muster to get over an unpleasantness or to heal a wound which life or human selfishness inflicts. A generosity and forgiveness that reaches beyond, that's always ready to go the extra mile, which stretches your hearts and spirits, as St. Paul says in the second reading, more than your patience sometimes might allow. This is what will earn you your endurance. Christian marriage isn't complicated. It's just demanding. It's difficult in what it asks of us. One of the hardest things it asks of us is humility. Marriage can be a lonely and one-sided relationship, but one spouse believes that he or she is right. Ironically, the strongest marriages are couples who know their weaknesses, limitations, and vulnerabilities, and can also cherish each other's gifts and strengths. True love is honest enough to recognize that in marriage, as in any meaningful relationship, we are incomplete, half-finished, a work in progress. We depend on the scaffolding of faith, friends, and family, and above all, each other's patience to keep going. I want to finish on your first reading, like a bold choice for reading, for all sorts of reasons. An interesting book in the Song of Songs. It's a book of poetry, an unlikely book in the Old Testament, full of law and wars and all sorts of things. And it's unique for two reasons. First and foremost, and I think this is why you might have unconsciously picked it, it's narrated, it's the only book in the Bible narrated by a woman. So the woman speaks, is the voice of the woman the whole way through, which makes it different in the Bible. And also, funny enough, it's one of those books in the Bible that makes no mention of God whatsoever, from beginning to end. And yet it's full of the intimacy of God. Psalms, a book, so sometimes take it down and read it when you're sent down on the back in the long lockdown period, and take down the Song of Songs. It's a love poem of two lovers, a series of love poems, two lovers enraptured in the beauty of each other. In fact, almost common word, it comes up in the reading today. But the whole way through it, they just keep saying to each other, the whole way through, you're beautiful, you're beautiful, you're beautiful. And that's what they keep saying in many ways. And poetic imagery is extraordinarily rich and sensuous, even erotic, almost blushing in parts. It celebrates God's presence in tenderness, joy, sensual and physical intimacy, mutual longing, desire, and esteem. I think maybe just to finish, it says two things, very simple things for you people here today. Firstly, never forget the beauty that you saw when you first met each other, when you first met by the ATM in Cashel one day. And you quickly discovered over a long coffee, so long that you had to be evicted by the coffee owner, the cafe. And so enraptured that you, so the beauty that you have in your little boy, Kieran, and the other qualities that complete and complement you, beauty in life, that you can go to live together as a family. Just always hold that when things are difficult, to remember that. Secondly, the Song of Songs is captured in the last word also of Eimear, that when you love each other, and not when you love another person, you see the face of God. And so do we. It's not only ourselves that see each other. In the beauty of your love, we also see the love of God. And all who come to know you will see that love and that beauty. That's the essence of the sacrament that you confer on each other today. The beauty of your love, your vocation, which is not just for yourselves, it's also for us and for others. For that reason, every wedding is a sort of society wedding. Because your love for each other, the beauty of your love for each other, breathes God's life and beauty into a world that needs it so much. Eimear and Kieran, as you set yourselves as a seal upon each other's heart today, we pray for you that the flame will never go out, as the Song of Songs says, and that no flood can quench, no turn strong your love. We pray that both of you, that you'll have a long journey together, but it won't feel long. And that if there are mountains that you have to climb, that you climb them together, and you grow closer with the climb. And from the vantage of every mountaintop of life, may you see more clearly and love more dearly. Now the moment comes, so I have to stand.
Dear children of God, you come to this church so that the Lord may see your love in the presence of the priest and of this community, and in front of your family and friends and all who are joining us tonight in the way. Christ blesses this love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, which we saw when we lit those candles, but now our special sacrament strengthens you to fulfill the duties of your married life. Kieran and Eimear, you are about to celebrate this sacrament, so I ask you, have you come here with your own free will and choice of love and compulsion to marry each other?
Amen.
Will you love and honor each other in marriage all the days of your life?
Amen.
Are you willing to accept with love the children God may send you and bring them up in accordance with the law of Christ in his church?
Amen.
So invite you then to be careful for God and your family and friends and the church your consent to become husband. Here, and Kieran, I say to you, please have to be. Even do you say to me,
Kieran, to me,
where this ring is a sign of our faith. Give you this gold and silver tokens of all possess.
Give you this gold and silver tokens of all possess.
Congratulations. If you can give them a round of applause. Sacrament of marriage, that they pray together and please God, that as we in the years to come, we'll remember always to pray for each other and also with each other. So that this be the first of many prayers you say for each other and with each other in the years to come. So I invite you to pray the prayer of the newly married.
We thank you, Lord, and we praise you for your presence to us that day. You have given us to each other. Now we give ourselves to you. We ask you, Lord, make us one in your love, give us one in your peace. Take care of our marriage, bless our home, make us gentle, keep us faithful.
For Kieran and Eimear, that the Lord who has brought them to this happy day will keep them forever in fidelity and love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, hear us.
For our community and our families who welcome Christ into their lives, that they learn to receive Him in the poor and suffering people of this world. Lord, hear us.
Thank you.
for the faithful departed, and especially those for those whom we ourselves have loved, that God will one day unite us again in the joys of our eternal home. Lord, hear us.
In the liturgy of today, the 1st of January is the feast of Mother Mary, the Mother of God. And in the Gospel of the day, it's the visit of the shepherds, and as they leave the manger, she treasures these things in her heart. So that would be my prayer for you as well today, that you would treasure this day always in your hearts, like Mary treasured all the mysteries of time to give birth to her child. And in her maternal care, we trust you both that she cover you both this day with the mantle of her maternal care as the Mother of God. So we pray together for you through her intercession. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. So now I invite everyone else to be seated, but Mary and I are going to bring up the gifts and present them.
Serve to increase the children of your daughter Jehovah.
confidence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish the wonder of this twofold design. By the birth of children brings beauty into the world, their rebirth and baptism gives increase to the Church through Christ our Lord. And through him the angels and all the saints sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim, Holy, Holy, Holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. And blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon the way that you fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he drew bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory.
Happiness, may they praise you, Lord. In sorrow, may they seek you out.
after a happy old age, together with the circle of friends that surrounds them, may they come into the kingdom of heaven, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, "Peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your people, your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen." And may the peace of the Christ child of heaven with you always. And so we can't exchange beside the peace and say, "Baby, what do you do?" So peace be with you all. Pray together. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Under the guise of red and white, behold the Christ child of Bethlehem. Behold the light of the darkness cannot overpower. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. And blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am worthy that you should enter under my roof, but I will say the word.
Even when the dark when they start upon a building, are careful to test out the staff. Make sure that planks won't slip at visit points. Secure all ladders, tighten bolted joints. And yet, all of this comes down when the job is done, showing off walls of sure and solid stone. So if, my dear, there sometimes seems to be old bridges breaking between you and me, never fear. We may let the scaffolds fall, confident we have built our home.
We pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that the power of the sacrament we have received may find growth in these your servants, Eimear and Kieran, and that the effects of the sacrifice we offer may be felt by all, through Christ our Lord. Amen. So, before we come to the final blessing, just again to wish you both well today and every day. The sun is shining, and today it's God will continue to shine for you both. And just want to say thanks to everybody who's involved, everybody here who's involved, everybody's in a job. So thanks to you all. Not only have you got people to say, but all of you for the prayers and the music. I want to thank John and Kieran for lovely music. And really kind of adds an awful lot to the day and really brings it to the sermon. And our readers, those who are the prayers of the faithful, I want to thank Kathleen, our service, to photographers, and for bringing us online to the world wide web. Out there to all of your friends and family neighbours who are into following you today. So, as part of our lives on today, that's so much of our, we have to relay so many of our sermons online. It's a great gift, a great facility of technology to have to be able to do that as well. So, we're delighted to have you join us online as well. So we all have a safe travel over to Kildare, familiar road, two of us took so often up and down, and as often you might talk often to your grandparents as well in the country. So look, we'll see each other up there near Youth, where we often used to summon you. And so look, I might have a blessing on you both and everybody here, so we'll conclude with the final blessing and we'll have our chats later on. So we stand for the final blessing. May God the Eternal Father keep you, Eimear and Kieran, of one heart and in love for one another, that the peace of Christ may dwell in you and abide always in your home. Amen. Eimear and Kieran, may you be blessed in your children, already in Kieran Hogue. Have solace in your friends and enjoy true peace with everybody. Amen. Eimear and Kieran, may you be witnesses of the world to God's charity, so that the afflicted and needy who have known your kindness may one day receive you thankfully into the eternal dwelling of God. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God come down upon us this day and in the coming year. In the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. And the joy of the Lord is our strength. Let us hold peace to love and serve the Lord. Thank you.
That's something to do.